Janet's a tent maker. She's a nurse from the Philippines working in a very difficult, closed country. And one Sabbath, when my wife and I were visiting with her, Janet said to us, "Pastor, I don't know what to do. I'm wasting my time here. For 17 years I've been working in this country and nobody's coming to church, nobody's taking Bible studies, nobody's been baptized. I'm just wasting my time here." Well, I didn't know exactly what to say to her except to encourage her that sometimes we don't see all the results. But the next day, Janet asked my wife and I if we would go visit a friend with her. We said, sure. As we drove through town and talked, I expected we were going to see a Filipino family. And I praise the Lord when anybody gives their hearts to Jesus, Filipino or otherwise. But as we turned the corner and drove up toward this huge house, I knew that it wasn't a Filipino flat. This was a massive Muslim mansion. I had never been in a house like that before. I didn't know for sure what to do. But I knew that inside the door would be this huge ornate visiting room and that's where all men had to go unless they were part of the family. So I figured we'd go in there and we would visit with the family and this would be a nice visit. But as they opened the door and saw that it was Janet, they hugged her and welcomed her and us right into the house. We walked up the stairs with them and went right into their family room and sat down to visit. The ladies took off their burkas and veils and talked to us in jeans and t-shirts. This was amazing. I couldn't pinch myself openly, but I was thinking, wow, Lord, this family is accepting me into the center of the house because they consider Janet, your Adventist messenger here, to be part of their family. This was a wealthy family. They owned many businesses throughout the city. And after we had visited for a little while, it was a Friday, the men got up and excused themselves and said they'd be back in a few minutes. They were going to the mosque to pray. After a few more minutes, the women got up and they said, "We're going to go in the other room and prepare refreshments." But I knew that they were going to pray. This was a devout Muslim family. So I was a little bit surprised when the family had left the room and Janet got up and said, "Pastor, look." She got up and walked over to the big screen television with all of its satellite system and remotes and everything, and she pushed the button. And the first thing that came up on the screen was the last thing they had been watching, Adventist television. I looked at Janet and I said, "Janet, is this family, this Muslim family, watching Adventist television?" And she said, "Well, yes, Pastor, they are." I said, "How did that happen?" She said, "Well, I found a cooking program that I thought they would like, and I showed it to them, but a few weeks went by and they weren't watching it. So one day I went to them and said, you know, could I program that into your favorites? And I put it right at the top. And to humor me, they began watching a few minutes of that program each day. And then they watched a few more. And then they began to watch the whole thing. And then they started watching what came before it and what came after it. And she said, now, Pastor, they watch everything. Dwight Nelson and Doug Batchelor and Mark Finley and all of the other Adventist preachers. As we left that home later that day, I said, Janet, you haven't been a failure here. They may not be sitting in church with you on Sabbath, but there are families whose lives have been impacted that never would have watched these programs if it wasn't for you. They would never stop their dial on a Christian program. They think Christians live like the soap operas. They think all Christians drink alcohol and eat pork. They think Christians are heathens. They want nothing to do with Christians. But because they loved you, they were willing to listen to the program that you asked them to listen to, and it's impacting their lives. Janet is a tent maker. For many years, your faithful tithes and mission offerings have supported a small church in Janet's adopted country. It's true, it's a church of foreigners. They're tent makers like Janet. They're working at various jobs in that country, but their lives are impacting the people they work with. And although they may not be sitting with them in church, they will be walking on the streets of gold with them. If you feel God calling you to use your profession to help enter an unentered country or city or community, then go to the website te.adventistmission.org to learn more about being a tent maker.